Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. We got Young Saliva.
Ooh! AKA Daddy.
Yes. Sorry, I did it wrong.
I need my full name.
We have Daddy.
There we go.
AKA Young Saliva. Bam. How's that mixtape coming?
I haven't started yet, but
I feel like you can rap.
You know what's weird? It's like I can rap, but it's like on my own time, or I can write down. But if you ask me to freestyle, it's like I'm saying cat, hat, bat, sat,
you that
fat.
Works.
You know, it's like
that
I get like really scared because I take it seriously. You know,
okay.
So it's like if someone puts me in front, I'm like,
what if we get a little flow? So like,
oh god.
But like you said, so I used to eat donuts and they made me real fat.
I can't do it. It's like so much pressure, and I'm so embarrassed by it because I'm like, just do it, just say words,
yeah.
And I'm like,
you ate my own.
Yeah,
ate choked.
Literally choked,
yeah.
Choked, and I like to think that I'm not scared, but like
yeah.
Freestyle, I choke,
yeah.
I die.
Battle rap is terrifying.
I know,
absolutely,
but it's like,
terrifying.
When
I love
I'm like
it,
home, I say some shit and I'm like, that.
Yeah, you're like,
good,
oh, okay,
that's good.
Okay.
You know, write it down, and then when I'm out there, I'm like. I don't even know how to start. Like, my thoughts to try to rhyme, they just are blank, and I'm just like, you suck. But at home, I'm like, good.
I can just imagine for like an hour straight, you're in your living room, just knocking out all these rhymes and sees you walk out the door.
I get it sometimes. Like, sometimes I'm like, oh, like.
Do you just rap to your pig?
No, not Piggles. He's a piece of shit. He doesn't deserve it.
What do you do?
Okay, so he has like this. I've been doing a lot more research on pigs than I initially did when I got the pig.
I was gonna say
because when I first got the pig, I didn't do too much research. You know, I just wanted it, and then I got it the next day.
Mm-hmm.
I found a farm and then got it. And now I'm like looking up research. I have like a roommate, and then my brother's staying with me for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But he's disrupting like the food chain in the house. So in the food chain, it's like me, my roommate, the pig, and the pig knows that. But now it's like me. My roommate, my brother, the pig,
yeah.
And the pig knows he's like notched down one, so
yeah.
He's feuding with my brother so heavily, attacking him. If my brother goes in the kitchen to get food, Piggles knows like he's gonna eat some of the food, and he's like, that's my food, like I'm third, you know. And then they get into these fights all the time, and he's attacking him in his sleep, and I'm just like, I don't know how I raised a bad pig. I'm so nice. I would never attack anyone. And he's just attacking everyone. And so now, every time my brother goes to the kitchen, he has to give Piggles some food. I was like, collateral. Like,
yeah.
Here, you know, take some. And now they're like, okay. But for a good, like, month, I was like, this isn't going to work.
But how do you know that he wasn't just trying to protect the food for you? Thinking, like, I don't know this new entity that's in the house.
Because if it was, like, me or food, like, he's a pig. He has, like, he has no, like, willpower against food. Like, he'll always choose food. If it was me dying... And one Cheerio, he'd get the Cheerio.
You think so?
I know so. He just like can't help himself. So it's like you can't even be mad at it. I should have named him Grump because he's so mean sometimes.
You had so much love.
I love out of him, but he just is like, I can keep it, you know, honest. Like has some behavioral
yeah.
issues.
But that's your dude.
Yeah.
That's your dude.
That's my dude, yeah. That's my dude. But he's attacking people, dude. and I'm like, oh my god.
So then what was it like the first time that he attacked your brother? We're just like, oh my god, what is happening?
I anticipated it because he was displaying signs of aggression. So when my brother came, I gave him a warning, like, hey, the pig's going through something right now. Like, he's gonna attack you for a little bit, he'll get over it. And then we really, like, really watched his behavior, and we just noticed whenever it was anything involving food, he just would, like, evolve to mean Piggles. Like, I don't know.
So what does he do? He's, like, biting him?
He'll be like, and then he'll just attack, but he's attacked smartly. He'll wait till you're not looking,
oh.
And then he'll go for your Achilles.
Do pigs have sharp teeth?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
He has manglers, like, going everywhere.
Oh, my
God.
He
has one good one that he knows is, like, the kill shot.
Yeah.
Like, this tooth, he knows if he gets you, like, you're done. So we avoid that tooth.
So has your brother been bitten?
Oh, yeah.
Like, puncture wounds?
Oh, yeah. So I'm like, I don't know, letting anyone over right now.
Yeah.
I don't know what's wrong with him. But I do know. I like, you know, it's just he's having a problem with my brother getting the food before him.
Yeah.
And it's just like a weird thing that I'm like, you know, I shouldn't even have probably spoke about. My pig's okay. He's happy. He's loving. But he's just going through some puberty. I don't really know.
So it is. He's growing.
Yeah, he's going through growing pains.
Is your brother older or younger?
Older. All my brothers are older.
Okay. And how many brothers do you have?
Four.
Oh, yeah. We talked. Yeah. Four brothers.
And oh,
so
yeah.
How do they feel, or how does your brother that's living with you right now feel about the pig attacking him? Does he understand? It's like, oh, you know, I get
at
it.
At first.
Or is he just, like, mad?
No, at first he was mad. Now they kind of have this understanding of, like, a love-hate relationship.
Yeah. So they play together.
They can
now
mutually live together. But when it comes to food, Piggles will still bite that ass. But it's a lot better. And it gets better every day. But it's still just, like, messy, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm scared that Pickles is going to, like, kill him in his sleep. I don't really know.
You just come in and Pickles, like, them, is on
yeah,
his throat.
I keep them separate. I keep them separate. Like, they have to stay separate at night.
How big is Pickles?
He's about 65 pounds.
Oh, I thought he was, like, I thought he was, like, little.
No, you know, he grew a lot.
So you have this pig.
He's not, like, 70... Larry Steve size. I don't know if you know Larry Steve. Larry Steve is huge.
Yeah, it's a...
yeah he's smaller than Larry Steve. But he did grow a lot.
Yeah. When you were anticipating him to get this big?
No, but I bought him with, like, you know, knowing that potentially he could be a boar. At least 7 more years. I got him. I checked the life expectancy. You know, I'm got him for a while. So.
And you do your best to take care of him.
Oh, yeah. No,
there you go.
He's good.
Life.
He's happy, he's taken care of, you know. But he just has attitude problems. I don't know if he's spoiled. I don't know if he's entitled. He just is a kind of a piece of pig a little bit, but it's okay.
So when you sit down on the couch, does he come and, like, sit next
to
you?
Oh, yeah. Loves to cuddle. Loves me. I'm, like, his number one.
Yeah.
I read that pigs, like, imprint love on one person and imprint hate on one person.
Oh.
I'm like, okay, he imprinted his love on me, imprinted his hate on my brother because he hates that.
So when you're taking care of a pig, especially of that size, like, do they start to stink? Do
no.
You have to, like,
smells
clean
great.
Them?
Never stinks.
Never.
Never, ever, ever, ever stinks. Never, which is weird because you think that it's a pig. It smells like...
on the mud
but no,
and stuff.
He smells great. We lather him up with some coconut oil.
Oh. So he gets moisturized and
moisturized,
massage?
Yeah, because their skin gets really dry, especially when they're outside, so you have to kind of coconut oil them up all the time.
Yeah. So, like, okay, so I'm trying to
no, go.
To
I can answer it all because...
So, okay, so you sitting on the couch, this 70-pound pig is just cuddled up against you.
Cuddled up, like, against me, or he'll fight to sit behind me. So he'll take his nose and be like,
and then you're just sitting up like this.
Yeah, and then he's just, like, laying kind of, like, resting on my butt and between my back and the couch, and I'm watching TV like this.
Just all messed up posture.
Yeah, because he just wants to be, like, cuddled and, like, warm. And
because he's not hairy, right?
No, he's hairy. He has, like, wire hairs.
Really?
Yeah, so I'll sit with him, and I'll feel, like, a little... It'll get me, and I'm like, it's, you know, because it itches. And I'm like, I'm like twitching, twitching next to the pig because his hair's so itchy.
And then they have hooves?
Yeah.
I know nothing about the anatomy
of the pig. Yeah, it's literally like he walks on his toes, and I feel bad because he has no flat surface. Yeah. He has his hooves, which have 2 points in the front, and that's all his weight on those.
Oh, no.
2 toes.
He's so big.
Imagine if we walked on these 2 fingers and our big toe and, like, our index toe on all fours. And that's how does it. That's how he does it. And I feel bad for him. I'm like, oh my God, I wish you could flat foot it a little bit. But he can't. And he just is always on the
tippy
toes.
Can you build him a little thing? To, like,
like a shoe?
Yeah.
I'm sure I could build, like, a platform, like something that could just go on there so it's flat.
And he's like, ah, this is what I need. And then he won't be angry anymore.
Oh,
he's like, that's what's messing him, making him mad.
Man.
All right, well, we're going to play Brawlhalla while we talk about stuff.
So
this is a game where you just kind of beat each other up. We're on a team, but
So
they just added some characters in this game at the bottom here.
Oh my God, it's you!
Yeah.
Oh, they.
So see those swords over there on the side?
Yeah.
So if you go over to them and you press the button that you've been
going.
Oh, no.
Oh.
So keep going this way.
Oh, God, I was looking at I do that all the time. I never look at my character. God.
So do you play any games when you go home?
I don't, to be honest. I have gaming systems.
Yeah.
But my brother is a little gamer hog.
Yeah.
He is, dude.
So he's like, oh, just sit and watch me play this.
He'll be like, it's a championship round. But, like, you know, the championship round goes for 27 rounds.
Yeah.
It's never the end.
Yeah.
So I'll be like, can I get a turn? He's like, it's a champion round.
No.
I'm like, all right, so that means no.
You gotta wait for me. Oh, God.
Yeah, okay. I mean, I was a heavy gamer when I was younger, though. Yeah. I would play video games the entire day.
You should be in it.
With my neighbor.
Do you have, like, a crew of kids you play games with?
I lived in, like a duplex home, like, you know, like two family style.
Yeah.
And my neighbor loved wrestling. They loved video games. And so we just would play video games for hours and hours and hours and hours. Even when we weren't home, I'd go and be like, can I play the game?
and
their mom would let me go and play the games, and I'd wait for them to get home.
It's so nice.
Yeah.
So many good stories of people playing games together.
Yeah.
That's all we want.
It really does unite people. Yeah. Oh, like, I'm dead?
Yeah. We're gonna win though.
I feel like I was killing everybody.
You were. You like movies, right?
Love.
You love movies. What kind of movies are you watching?
I'm loving. I love scary movies. That's my number one. I love to be scared.
Have you seen Ma?
I've been going to the theater. Like, I could pretty much, I watch every movie that's come out in the past, like, year in the movie theaters. I go, like, weekly. That's, like, my jam.
I'm so jealous. I want to see Ma so bad.
It was really good.
Yeah?
It was really good.
It's coming out soon, and I'll be able to watch it.
On, like, DVD. It was really good.
I got mad because, I was supposed to go see it with one of my friends, and then we couldn't go see it because I was just bouncing around too much.
Yeah.
And then it wasn't in theaters when I got back, and I was just like,
yeah, so Ma was really good. I love scary movies. I love to be scared.
You like to be scared in real life?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, it makes me feel alive.
Yeah.
And I love it. I love it.
So there's a difference between, like, do you like to be, like, jump scared, like someone jumped from behind a wall, or do you like to be, like, actually scared, like, I think someone's in my home?
I felt number two, and it was really scary.
Like, for real?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My God.
But no one was in my home. I still think someone was, because I was hearing. I'll tell you that story when I can concentrate in a second. But I hid in my closet. It was crazy with a little knifey, and I prepared myself like, oh, you're about to stab someone, and I had to mentally like get myself ready to. I thought I was gonna have to kill somebody.
Yeah.
It was really crazy.
It's terrifying.
I know. It really was. I was shaking like a leaf and had 911 on my little dial pad ready to hit it, but I never had to do it, so everything was okay. But it was. I still think someone was in my house that day.
See, I can do like movie scared or like, haunted house scared. But then when it gets like real scared, I'm like.
Yeah, no, I like fake scared, you know?
There
but
we go.
The real scare, it was really scary.
Yeah.
It was really scary.
What's the scariest thing, like fake scared? The scariest fake scare thing you've ever experienced?
The scariest fake, like a movie scare or something that I thought was real?
Like, yeah.
Okay, scariest
fake. Like a haunted house or, like, what's the universal scary thing?
Not a haunted, I mean, when I was younger, this family, where it was like nice enough to create haunted houses for like all the kids. And so they did, but their haunted houses were legitimately, they had like levels and it went up to level 12.
Oh God.
And
it was like, it's like real haunted house.
It was real haunted house. And they, I don't know their budget, but it was like amazing. And that scared but you know, it's crazy. The Ring, I saw The Ring in theater.
Yeah.
And I was almost not able to sit and watch it. My feet were up, like my feet weren't able to be on the ground. And then I was getting like sick, like I wasn't breathing correctly watching it because I was so scared. I was so scared that I literally, it was affecting my breathing. And I was like, I gotta get out of here.
That's how I was when I watched Blair Witch for the first time.
Oh my God.
But it was after, so like I went to see it with my mom, and by the end of it, like the credits were rolling, and we looked at each other, we're like, that was a terrible movie. Like I couldn't stand it. It was,
really?
I thought it was so bad. We won! You got a ton of kills. Look.
Really?
We looked at each other, we were like, that movie was terrible. But then, even to this day, like, I can't go in the woods at night.
Who would?
I can't do it.
Who would?
I'm actually terrified. Because, like, there's a creek near our house, and, like, we would always play, like, the kids would play, like, there. We, like, made, like, a rope tire swing, this little tree house. But then, so there were sometimes where we used to go, like, we have our flashlights, because, you know, it would get dark, like, earlier, like, in the fall or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so like we have our flashlights, and it was right across the street from one of our friends' houses, so like their parents were cool because we were right there. But after I saw Blair Witch, I couldn't even do that. I was like, I know I can still see the street. I have no desire to be in the woods.
What about Paranormal Activity? When that first came out, I thought that it was real.
Insane.
I thought it was real.
Insane.
And then I found out it was fake, and I was slightly disappointed. But it scares
the shit.
I believe in all of that. I believe that like, I mean, I try not to even talk about it because I feel like it'll make me more susceptible to getting possessed. Don't want it. But yeah, I believe in that so heavily,
yes.
And Paranormal Activity scared the out of me.
When I saw it, It was like 6 o'clock or so. It was earlier in the day because as soon as I got done watching it, I got in my car, I drove to my best friend's house, and I drug her out of her house, put her in my car, and we went to the movies. I was like, you have to see this. She's like, oh, that sounds good. Yeah, I went to it again immediately.
Did you think it was real?
I didn't think it was real, but okay. I thought it was very good.
Okay.
Because, like, especially the part where they're dragging the dude down the hallway, woo! I was like, what? What? But that is my second favorite scary movie
first.
Universe. What?
What's the first one?
The Purge.
Purge.
Purge,
really?
To me, is the best movie universe ever.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought The Conjuring was.
Conjuring's
really,
great, but
really
see, I really like The Conjuring. I don't like Annabelle.
I didn't see the new one. I fell off of Annabelle after like the first one.
Yeah.
But
it's like I always see them, but Annabelle's not my like.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay.
Purge good,
but
is cool.
I like more of the.
Would you purge? Honestly, let's be honest. Let's be honest with ourselves. No, I would stay inside.
If you don't know what The Purge is, you don't need to know what it is. We're going to have this conversation with the people that are old enough. So I don't know if I would purge because I'm not in that situation. So there's certain experiments that have been done, so specifically the Milgram experiment, where there is a said researcher and they have the person come in and do the test, right? Mm-hmm. And the person who's doing the test says, they ask the person on the other side of the wall a trivia question. If they get it wrong, then they have to press the buzzer and it shocks them, the person on the other side. And every time they get, I'm paraphrasing, every time they get a question wrong, they have to turn up the level of shock.
Ooh.
So it gets to the point where they're on like level 6 and the person's like, oh God, stop, okay, I'm done. And then they look to the researcher, like, do I keep going? And the researcher, yeah, it's fine, keep going. Till they get to the point where some people were going all the way up and the person on the other side of the wall was passing out.
Yeah.
Now they didn't know it was just a recording, but the whole premise is that you say you wouldn't do stuff, but the majority of people, when put in the position of having to listen to an authoritative figure, they're most likely going to comply with what the society is or what the authority tells them to do. Because like, have you seen all the movies?
Yeah.
I still haven't seen the last one because I'm catching up on all my friends, mm-hmm. like on them. Yeah. It's like the first three, absurd to me. They're incredible. It's just an incredible, like, scenario. It's an interesting question.
It is an interesting thought, and not a lot of people will be honest with themselves.
Exactly.
But you know,
because like
we're honest people.
I love
here.
The characters in the movie and like how it's presented. Spoilers on The Purge, by the way, and how it's presented. Like, oh, people are just doing this, and then you find out like it's the government.
Yeah,
that's really doing this, and so like people are doing it, but the numbers like our purge numbers are low. So like get people out there and like. That makes me think like, oh, you know, well, yeah, there'd be some sort of resistance force, and we'd fight against the purge and this and that. Like. But would we?
Do you remember the original concept? It's like, it helps
lower
crime and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Do you believe in that? Do you think that that is...
Do I think that would happen for real?
Do you think that that would, like lower crimes
like
and killings?
The beast?
Yes.
I don't know.
Because I almost think like it might.
There's
not that
chance.
I want it, but I feel like in the long run, you know, if people had a night where they could get away with any type of crime, they might feel less like...
Likely to do it
compelled
on the
compelled to do it like any
they know
other
like
day.
Here's my window to do all my crime.
Yeah, you know,
like
then
if I,
like
if I
it,
do crime.
It lets it like releases whatever like endorphins you get from.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think it'll work, but I don't want it, but I feel like it might work.
Yeah. So back to just talking about it as like a entertainment thing. I like it because there's so many avenues that you can go. So like on that the first movie, so like the night of this purge.
Yeah.
And the next movie is like, okay, night of a different purge. But then they can always go back to like whatever purge night they want to and get, talk to who, or do the story perspective of whoever in the country they want to. Like, there's a million
It's endless. It's endless, opportunity to create a movie.
Yeah.
You know, they could go as far as they want.
It's so smart. And so, yeah, that's by far my favorite. But then, okay, so back to Paranormal Activity. Like, there's what, like 8 of them now? Something like that.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
Not 8, like 5.
5?
Really? Just a little
I did
bit.
I?
Just a little bit.
How many Paranormal Activities? Can we Google? I think there's at least 6.
How many Paranormal Activities are there?
Here's what I found.
Okay, film series. I mean, I wanted the answer, Siri, but I guess I will. You got me on the path. Hold on, keep it going. I'm still looking. Keep it going. Hold on.
Noah's got it.
How many?
I think they've done 6 with the 7th installments announced this year.
Ooh,
6?
See?
What was 5?
The Ghost Dimension.
Yeah.
I didn't watch that. What was 4?
So 4 was the marked ones.
That's the one that were there in the...
No,
the 5th was the marked ones. It was just
that's the one with the kids, like, they're like in the hood?
I never watched them. I don't know.
I think that's the one where, nothing happens
until
the end.
And like they're like in that kind of complex, and they yes.
Dude, okay.
That
so
was scary too.
More spoilers.
That was
so
scary too.
What messed me
I love
up
being
is like
scared.
It's so good.
Scare
so,
me.
So all of the all the paranormal activity is like something happens and something happens, something happens. And that one, I'm watching it for like an hour. Legit,
so much
nothing
felt.
Happens.
So much felt.
And what? And then he goes downstairs. And there's the portal, and he sees the girl from the first one walking through the house. I was like, oh my god, they were there. They were there.
I know.
Because something in the first one walked past. Like, they're so smart.
I know.
And then he's running, and there's all those witches. I was like, what? What is happening?
Oh my god, have you seen Hereditary?
Yes.
Ah!
Girl.
Tell me. Just
girl.
Tell, you didn't expect it, did you?
No.
I thought she was a main character.
Yes.
I was like.
Yes. We're good. Spoilers. Have you guys seen it? Do you care if we spoil it? Okay. Hereditary. When her head gets knocked off in that car ride, what? What? Yes. Exactly. Yuck saliva. I was losing my mind. It was absurd. Because then, even more, I was like, are you going to spit this coffee everywhere? Because what's even more messed up is
I have
when,
another weird question. Yeah.
When the mom wakes up and finally goes downstairs, because he didn't tell them that his little sister got beheaded on the drive home.
I put myself in his shoes, and he literally couldn't handle what had happened. He was such in shock that he pretended like it never happened.
Yeah.
Went home, went in his bed, went under his covers, and just sat there like,
yeah.
Didn't want to face the day.
No.
Like, didn't want to face the day. Didn't want it to be real. And then had to explain to his parents, I beheaded her.
Yeah.
You would tell, would you tell your, like, would you, I think I'm like, what would I do? I might be so, I don't know, like, I've been in situations where, this is not as dramatic at all, but like, one time my little sister fell down the stairs, and there was a lot of stairs, and I had time to go and be like, oh, I was frozen in fear, and I just like, I stood there and I listened to her fall down all the stairs, and I couldn't move, even when she landed, I like, was too scared to check on her, so I was just like, and I don't know because that's like freaky, and also I feel like they did that so realistically.
Yes,
that's like a realistic, like,
yes.
some people, like, I was like, wow, very well done.
Yes.
Because I felt some type of way.
Yeah,
I felt uncomfortable,
especially when they do the shot, like, because the whole time you're waiting, like, did he tell them, and then it shows the shot of her head on the side of the road with the flies. I was like, oh Jesus. Okay, so more scary movies, what's top ranked for you?
Top ranked. Conjurings are great. That scares me a lot.
The first Conjuring is the scariest one, right?
Scary.
With the clap clap.
The last one was really good. They've all been pretty solid, but yeah, the clap clap was that, for sure.
When they're sitting on the stairs and the hands came in?
Yep.
Out of here.
I like, I'm a big fan of, like, Chucky. Even though, like, the last couple movies have been doo-doo.
Yeah.
I just love him so much that I just can't help it. I just love that little guy.
What's the movie with the guy who's blind and the kids try to, like, steal from him in his house?
Oh! Don't Breathe?
Yeah.
Woo!
Did you like that?
Love that.
Yeah.
Love that.
That was so good.
What about the one where you can't make any noise? Because there's, like, the...
With, what's his name? Jim from The Office.
Can you believe...
So
spoiler! The dad died?
No!
What? No. I was like, no! I cried my eyes out. I cried.
Because you could see him making the decision. You could see it, but I'll be like,
cried.
Oh my
God. I couldn't believe it.
No.
And then the mom, she went through so many things.
Yo,
she's giving birth, stepped on the nail, has an alien in her house. I was like, women. I was like, I can never.
I was like in tears and pain for her when, because knowing
went
that she gave birth silently
stepped on
gave
a nail.
Birth. And while giving birth, walking downstairs, nail fully through her foot, knowing if she made any sound, her whole family was done.
Alien in her house.
She pulled it together.
Then family missing.
Put the baby, after she had gave birth, she put the baby in a thing. It was floating in the water. Like, what a woman.
Yeah.
What a woman.
Literally.
Gave birth and then had a shotgun in her hand, killing stuff.
Yeah, I could never.
My
She's
God.
Great.
I literally could never, because I can't have children. So. What a good movie.
That was a really great
movie. And there's only like a paragraph of dialogue.
How easy.
Yeah. What really got me was when the kids went back up on the tower and they lit the fire. And no other fire's lit. I was like, damn. My God.
Yeah.
They got everybody.
Yeah, it was
they
great.
Got everybody.
It was great. Have you seen Gerald's Game? Netflix?
No, what's that?
Okay, I don't want to tell you because then I'd give it away. It's a married couple have been married for a while. Sex life is a little bit not interesting anymore. So they go on to their cabin in the woods. And then shit goes down.
Okay. I love a good cabin movie.
Yeah. It's in, there's twists and turns that you wouldn't expect it. It's a really good
Gerald's
movie.
Game.
Yeah, Gerald's Game, Netflix. I watched it like 2 weeks ago. It's not like amazing, but it's very interesting and something that I haven't seen before, kind of in a movie. Like it was different. It had my attention the entire time.
Are you a conspiracy theory kind of person?
There are answers that we'll never know. He's at home with his kids and his wife sleeping, and I'm calling him at 2 a.m. like framing us both. Right. Just try, keep trying, never stop trying.
Da 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 da